I feel it's my duty to speak first, mostly because I don't like for my counter character to get a word in edgeways. I'm playing Beatrice in Much Do About Nothing. She's quite a feisty character, I think. It's quite opinionated and particularly likes expressing that opinion to Benedick, who plays the man that she loves to hate, I think is probably the best way to describe it. It's been described as a merry war, hasn't it?
A merry war.
A merry war of words and wit, probably.
More words in
yeah.
your case.
I'm not sure whether she realises how she feels for him throughout the course of the play, but I think in the end she probably gets her way. There
I play Benedick. I'm a soldier, returned from war. There's obviously some previous gone on between Beatrix and Benedick, so you get that sense that they've been fighting at this for a long time. And it starts with this whole really having a go at each other. And then basically they're stitched up by their mates, is how the play works out. Their friends conspire to undertake one of Hercules' feats, as they say, to get the two of them together. And they're both duped into believing that the other one loves them. And so eventually they fall in love. He declares his undying love for Beatrice, at which point she makes an unreasonable request, as all women do. And instead of it being chocolate or flowers, she says, "Kill my best mate." Charming. So he says, you know, on your bike. But then gives in, as all men do to women, eventually. But that's all resolved. And finally, they kind of get together, and it's all good.
I think the important thing to remember throughout the entire play is that Beatrice is an awful lot more intelligent than Benedick, and is more than likely totally aware of the fact that he is head over heels in love with her right from the beginning.
Which may have been the way Shakespeare wrote it, but I think you'll find that our director has cast this with Benedick as being the more intelligent, better looking of the two.
Is that what she told you? Is that why you accepted the role?
Yes.
She told me the same thing. I wonder you are still talking, Signor Benedick. Nobody marks you.
What? My dear Lady Disdain, are you yet living?
Is it possible Disdain should die while she has such meat food to feed it as Signor Benedick? Courtesy itself would convert to disdain should you come in her presence.
Then is courtesy a turncoat, for it is certain I am loved of all women, only you excepted. And I would that I could find it in my heart that I had not a hard heart, for truly I love none.
Ah, a happy blessing for all women. Or they would find themselves in the company of a pernicious suitor. I thank my God and cold blood that I am in the same humour as you in this. I should rather hear my dog bark at a crow than hear a man swear he loves me.
Oh, God, keep your ladyship still in that mind so some gentleman or other shall scape a predestinate scratched face.
Well, the scratching couldn't make it worse for a face such as yours.
Ooh, well, you are a rare parrot, teacher.
Well, better a bird of my tongue than a beast of yours.
Ooh, I would that my horse had the speed of your tongue and so good a continuer, but keep your way in God's name, I have done.
Oh, you always did end with a jade's trick. I know you of old.